Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2279, Minimize the Search Box and Smaller Tool Tabs. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Chell, and I have great news today. Two things that I just absolutely love that just came out to Office 365 Office Insiders. First thing I want to talk about is these things that are called tool tabs. These are the transient tabs, the tabs that come and go. And back in Excel 2013, that's where these screenshots are from, you know, we might have had something called Table Tools Design on two rows, which is just terrible. And now they've shortened that it's just Table Design, right? One row, doesn't take up two rows anymore, which is great. And here, if I click inside of a pivot table, we used to have Pivot Table Tools, Analyze, and Design. And now they just simplified it to Pivot Table Analyze, beautiful, and then Design. Or even, let's go to a pivot chart, where we used to have three, Analyze, Design, and Format. We now have Pivot Chart Analyze, Design, and Format, and I think that's brilliant. It makes perfect sense, and it's less space up there. I love this. And the best one, actually, I think they should all follow this. If it used to be Slicer Tools Options. If I choose Slicer, it's just called Slicer. That's all we need. You know, this shouldn't be called Shape Format. It should just be called Shape, and this should just be called Picture, right? So, kudos, Microsoft. This was brilliant. Make it even shorter. You know, you don't need to be so verbose. We don't need all those words. Just picture. That would be just fine. All right. So that's great news one. Now, we're going to step away from great news here for a second. This box, the search box, used to be called Tell Me. You press Alt-Q to get there. What is this thing? It's not Find. And look, it's offering me to insert a PowerView report. PowerView? Are you serious? Excel 2013, it's Throwback Thursday. I mean, who uses PowerView anymore? It's not even in the ribbon. All right, here's another one. On the Data tab, we have a command called Text to Columns, right? And let's say I'm just too lazy to click on the Data tab, so I press Alt-Q to go up into the search box, and I search for Text to Columns. And they actually offer me the right thing, but they call it Convert Text to Table. What? I don't even recognize it. The first time I recorded the podcast, I skipped right over it, said it didn't show up. But then I started to look for other things, like split columns, and that same weird command kept coming up, Convert Text to Table. And sure enough, that is Convert Text to Columns Wizard. Well, why do they call it Convert Text to Table? And I said, okay, well, that's interesting. I did search for split, and they came up with the right command, even though they didn't call it the right thing. Let me try Alt-Q. I search for parse. That's the other word for split. And they think that I misspelled paste. And they offer me a dictionary definition of parse to analyze a sentence into its parts, but they don't tell me how to parse. In theory, this thing should be useful to get to things that are not in the ribbon. You should be able to go to anything, commands not in the ribbon, type that command and have it pop up. But the ones I tried, like calculator, Alt-Q, nothing. 5-point star. Okay, well, they did get that one that it's a shape, but they give me the whole gallery of shapes instead of getting me directly to the 5-point star. How about close all? That's one that I use a lot. Not there. My disappointment with this search box just is monumental. I was disappointed when Tell Me showed up in Excel 2013, and while it's changed, I'm not sure I'm ever going to use it. Here is the great news. Just yesterday, in the version that came out to Office Insiders, File, Options, General, fifth item, collapse the Microsoft search box by default. Click OK, that search box goes away. It becomes a tiny little icon up here. I can still press Alt-Q if, for some reason, I would need it. Standing ovation. Hey, if you like these tips, please click subscribe and don't forget to ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.